So, as we were talking about before, we all thought this was going to be an easy cop, and we were already thinking about doubling up on these 2017 rolls, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we went so far as to saying, like, you know, like, if we hit every single store raffle, plus we can get one or two pairs online, mm-hmm. that means we'll be fucking swimming in royals,
swimming
right?
Royalty, yeah.
What happened to that plan?
April Fool's fucking got us.
Yeah, we did get April fooled, right?
Yeah.
Let's talk about this. Who wants to do this?
We were right. Let's start on a positive
note.
Yeah, that's true, actually. We were right in our predictions.
So if anyone that follows our podcast on Instagram, I chose a very choice selection of a clip from last week's episode. And that clip was Jason Nostradami.
Yeah.
He predicted that, you know what, why don't you just say what happened?
That it was going to be April Fool's. And
that nothing was going to release.
Nothing was going to release.
So you were almost right.
I was, you were, what, like 5% release?
You were 95% right.
I was 95% right. That's correct, yes.
1%, not even.
So what I have heard.
We don't know, right?
Okay, now we got to play this very carefully. Allegedly, there were a lot of units. The number I've heard is really, really high.
Like and double.
Double jam. What? Double Space Jam.
Two times Space Jam.
We don't officially know what the Space Jam online
availability.
We don't know what the online availability of the Space Jams were, so we can only estimate or guess that these were double the Space Jam onlines, right? So these Royal ones were supposed to be very, 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 very heavily stocked for Nike.ca. And what had happened was midnight came. We all got into queue to buy. We selected our size. I thought I did a pretty good job not fucking up the size selection this time. So I got into queue. And after, I don't know, like 30 or 45 minutes,
sold out.
I said it was sold out. And then this process repeated over and over again until it officially said it was sold out. And then KicksDLCA, shout out. Said that they're sold out and he'll look into it, blah, blah, blah. And then today's Wednesday, and it's been announced that, I guess it's safe to talk about now, because by the time this goes up, it'll be Saturday, Sunday, right? That Nike.ca kind of didn't release the entire available stock to the Canadian online
consumers. Base.
So the number I've heard is that they've sold, like, completed checkout was around 5%. Of total stock.
Mm-hmm.
5% of the total stock that was made specifically for the Canadian online consumers. This is the number I heard, allegedly.
Allegedly.
And this, it's all estimates. And the remaining 95%, what we have all heard by now is that Nike.ca is not going to follow up with the re-release of the remaining stock.
Correct.
So approximately 5% of the total online available stock made it into the hands of the consumers. So now, how much more rare is this Royal One 2017 in Canada? It's about
95%.
5%, yeah. Pierre's almost got it. So now that we know this alleged fact, how do you guys feel about the fact that we were able to all get a pair?
I love you, Mark.
It feels pretty good. Yes,
still bittersweet.
Yeah. In fact, a lot of
people who've got fucked over.
Yeah, a lot of people were like, "I'm not gonna spend money on resale. They're gonna be so easy to get once online hits."
I'm not gonna go hit an extra raffle. I'm not gonna go line up at the places that are still doing first.
Do you think there are a lot of people that just didn't go out of their way, quote unquote, to enter raffles because they thought the online cop was going to be so easy?
I mean, if it's out of their way, yeah.
Not everyone lives where we live.
Well, exactly. Right? We're lucky where half a dozen, well, four stores or whatever it is, or in one mall, you know, that handle the six raffles.
But you have to go and do it like on different days.
That's true.
But I hit more raffles than I
And it paid off, dude.
Right.
Yeah. You got your pair. You got sort of your pair.
Yeah.
So, like, all of us put in the work, and then most of us got paid off with that work, and then Pierre got the fucking favor.
Yeah, five raffles.
You did the work.
I did.
You didn't get the payoff like
expected,
but you did get a pair.
We need to acknowledge the fact that it's been said now, confirmed through some of the screenshots from guys reaching out to Nike.ca on Twitter and some of the other social media, that there was an error, obviously, within the website within their e-commerce portion of the website, which we also did confirm that, you know, last week, that if they were going to be bumping up numbers, that there's no way that their website was going to be able to handle it.
We all predicted that their website was going to have some sort of huge hit, and whether or not they were going to be able to keep up with it, that's an issue we all know. But we didn't know that it was going to be so bad that they're just going to be like pulling the plug mid-release.
Yeah.
The fuck was that? Did I say something?
Yeah, that's it's just like, well, it's comparative to Adidas.
Yeah, Adidas doesn't fucking
at least you didn't have to do CAPTCHA.
Well, here's the
you just had to sit around and watch a spinning wheel and wait for your fucking item to.
Here's the thing that I posted earlier on Twitter is that
you're not at checkout yet.
Some people were talking about how Nike fucked up and like what I think about Nike now, and what I had to say was, even though Nike completely botched this online release, they still were able to sell more pairs, 10 times allegedly, 10 times more pairs of Royal Ones than what the triple white Ultra Boosts were made available online.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm.
We're not talking about how many got sold online, the triple whites. It's how many were available. And with Nike fucking up, they were still able to give consumers 10 times the amounts of what Adidas thought was an okay amount to give to their public, the consumers.
Yeah.
So I'm not saying that Nike is fucking awesome and that they didn't fuck up. They totally fucked up.
Yeah.
But Nike so overestimated that what their consumers want that they were able to like distribute enough to at least capture some of the market, whereas in Adidas is like you get like this and it's nothing, right? So how do you guys feel about the future of e-commerce and specifically Nike and Adidas.ca doing business from now on when it comes to hype releases? We know that they've always been a problem, so what is your thoughts on the future of this?
Nike's only mistake here is pulling the plug entirely and not allotting the stock back to the Canadian people.
Do you guys have any guesses to why they won't re-release the remaining of the stock?
It's already been said why.
Yeah, officially? Yeah,
it was on Twitter.
Okay, so what did you allegedly hear?
Allegedly heard that they want to implement the sneakers app in Canada.
Fair enough.
And so
just do it now. Do it like today.
Do it for next Saturday.
Let me get another pair for Saturday.
And I guess, you know, for whatever reasons, the online shopping experience isn't secure enough. So they want to implement the sneakers app in Canada to improve it. But that won't be happening until summer.
Right.
So I would expect that any other, we don't really have too many other hype releases, but any sort of release that garners any sort of interest is going to be difficult. And will be not the greatest shopping experience until that comes in. And Joe probably has an opinion on the whole sneakers app thing because we both use it, you know, through the American site, and how that will supposedly or allegedly or supposedly like change how we shop, and that it'll be a huge improvement. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Did you actually try Saturday morning for them?
Yes. Yeah. I was like instantly denied.
See, and it said you did not get them.
Yeah.
See, I had payment issues. Like, people think that sneakers...
I get those things all the time, too. It's like, there's too many people on there, and you can't get through with the payment. Or you're trying to do the draw, and you can't even sign in to do the draw. And then the fucking hour runs out, and then you're like, you don't even get the draw. I've had that happen on, like, numerous shoes.
But the issue that happens with me is the payment information. Well, I'll throw some screen caps up for people who are actually watching this to be able to see, and I'll send some screenshots of the procedure, because it's usually like a 3 or 4 click, and if you've got it set up that your
thumbprint
ID is set up there, that is the final authenticator to run your purchase through. So it brings up, you know, you'll have a shoe and it's all dressed up in a nice screenshot of like the promo images that you see in the bottom left corner. It'll go coming soon for a release or whatever, and then at 7 a.m. the price will come up for the Royal Ones. It'll say $160 buy. You press that, and then it'll bring up your information that's already preloaded, your name, address, payment information, and then your size. And then it's just one big solid bar, buy now, thumbprint scan, done. So, but it, for the bread ones and now for this one, you buy, it's already pre-selected your size, and then the payment information's not there for whatever reason. It's preloaded ahead of time, so it's just a three bang.
What were you using for your payment option?
Well, I've got four different payment options on there since
I know other guys that use it as well, and they sometimes say that you have to use PayPal and not your credit card, or you have to use your credit card and not PayPal.
Yeah, no, it's
like, so why would they give that? Why would they give you that as an option? If
it is an option, but sometimes if you choose one or the other, it just doesn't work.
That's stupid.
I know it's glitches in the system.
So it's a glitch, right? It's not on
purpose. None of my credit cards were available to select as payment. The line for payment option was blank, and then when I went to click it and go select my PayPal option, then it would give me thumb scan, and then it would just back out, and then it would reset all over. PayPal was no longer in the payment selected screen or little tab, and then I'd have to do that over and over again. So sneakers is not the answer.
But then you even get this, you get to the sneakers part and you actually purchase it, but then you're in line where it says got it, and we'll let you know whether you get it or
not. That eventually did happen, but now we're talking we're talking 40, I bet you it was 40 minutes.
It's like going to the doctor's office and then they fucking say, go, now you can go, you're in the waiting room, now you go into the other waiting room.
That's just it, is that people, it's just a shinier interface where people think that it's your three clicks away. No, everything's preloaded.
But no bots, though, right? So you're combating bots.
I've heard.
It's a matter of time before someone figures it out. I have
personally seen people with like 20 different accounts for the same shoe.
Yeah.
I don't know how they, obviously there's ways around it.
You can with sneakers, but you have to have like a U.S. cell phone number.
Well, eventually when it comes to Canada, we're going to be able to bypass all the U.S. bullshit. And like people will still exploit this app because it's an app-based fucking thing, right?
Yeah.
Can you do it on your laptop or your computer and shit?
Yep.
Okay. So whatever the case is, Jason, how do you, like, Joe seems like you're not a big believer in this app. I'm not
convinced it's the be all and end all. Okay. Like you can get low key releases right now, and I'll while you guys are talking, I'll bring up some stuff and we can take a look at it.
Well, it seems
I'm not
like
convinced it's the answer.
It's there's no perfect solution, I don't think, as of right now. But Jason, what do you knowing that you've used the sneakers app, how do you feel about the interface?
I think it's really slick, easy, you know, it's straightforward.
Yeah. It's like akin to Apple Store app, right?
Yeah, it's like you could sit at, you know, dinner and just like, oh, I feel like buying a pair of shoes, boom, 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 and you're done. And but as soon as you start getting to the more hyped releases, that's when it starts to get bogged down.
Yeah.
And I don't think they've figured out that portion of it yet.
So it's dope for buying shoes that's still sitting in their store.
Or a little bit lower, a little bit lower key things that, you know, like something with a lot of stock.
Yeah.
Still, you know, might not be the hypest of releases, but it has stock. I mean, but I still find that it's difficult. You know, I think there's a lot more people using this now, whereas when it first came out, there was less people using it. So that was a bit more difficult. But yeah, I like the interface. It's super easy. You can select what you want. You can change your size. You know, it gives you all those options.
Right.
But yeah, I think with any kind of technology, there's always going to be people who find a way around it.
Yeah.
Or there's going to be, but I think it has helped combat, you know, the bots where you could just sit on Nike.com and just like run them and put them in your cart and away you go.
So
at least that it's doing something.
Can we agree that the Nike.ca queue system has a lot of faults? As in, it can't keep up with demand. And
I guess so,
the web
but we
traffic.
Don't see that, right? Like as a consumer,
we'll never know.
You don't see
only
it.
The back end people know.
You just you just assume that people are fucking getting the shoes before you.
We don't.
Right? You don't
it's,
know.
It's frustrating because we don't know what's going on, and they don't have. Generally, they don't have a official statement to what happened to the release.
I would like to see that more. I would like to see Nike or whatever brand that we are trying to buy from that has like a botched release or
an
unsuccessful, like actually own up and actually talk about it more with their consumers.
That's tough,
right?
That's tough.
Something, right? Because a lot of people are
just an explanation, you know, even if it's bullshit.
And there's,
just so we know.
Sure, there's a lot of people that troll and there's a lot of people that are dicks out there that will say, just start shit for the sake of starting it. But I think, you know, for me, from a consumer, I'd be curious to know like if someone's actually interested in what the consumers think.
Right.
You know, I hope people hear it, and I hope Nike hears it from us, but you know, we're not the only ones.
The only problem is that, you know, there's like tens of thousands of people that want these shoes, and there's only so many pairs that made available, right? And the only problem is that they're never gonna meet the demand of these consumers as long as the hypey releases are made available in this number. And they don't need... They always have this elitist mentality where, you know what, we can fuck up every single launch and you'll still come back. And yeah. as sneaker collectors and consumers of these products, we prove them right time after time.
Yeah.
That's the biggest problem. It's almost like that fucking chicken and eggs question we had before when Peter just zoned out. How
zoning out right now? Thinking how, about this shit.
How, you know, like we always bash resellers, but like at the same time we buy resell shoes and we feed back into the market. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing, man. We can bash it all we want, but unless we completely boycott that practice, there's nothing that they need to change, right? So
no, and I wish there was some sort of like VIP or some sort of system where people who buy a lot of stuff get the recognition. But also like in the sense of not just like because you buy stuff.
So the rich get richer.
Because that could be just
a white man mentality, Jason.
No. Like taking into consideration that people are like going and like meeting, like the only way that people end up getting stuff are like influencers and like these other people that are in the community that have a bit more, you know, visibility and things like that to get stuff. And, you know, there's a lot of people who, you know, like all of us spend a lot of money on shoes, you know, to a certain extent, you know, and we don't always can't get it all through Nike.ca. You can't get it all. You have to go to different stores. But, you know, we're all building these relationships across multiple retailers and stuff. But,
yeah,
you know, it'd be nice to be able to somehow build that with Nike or Adidas or whatever.
Yeah.
It makes it, you know, a bit easier to get the things that you really, really True. Want, not just, through, that, you know, resell.
That's the utopian view of having,
sure.
you know, for me, I don't like online copying, but it gives me hope, right? Especially if you know Kicksteals will say
shout out.
Yeah, and I believe Kicksteals when he tweets about the quantities. It just gets disappointing when you don't see that quantities released. Yeah. I would rather, you know, spend time on a raffle, talk to someone.
Yeah. Get hooked up for retail.
No, like I mean
that paid off.
It's just it's online to me is bullshit, but it's there and I'll cop it because it's a chance.
Yeah.
Right? It's a chance. If they want to stay away from this whole brick and mortar thing, like you said, they got to reach out to their people.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I know this frustration always happens when there's a hype Adidas release with Adidas.ca, how poorly they manage inventory and availability and the fucking captcha loop. It's very, very frustrating trying to buy shoes online nowadays, especially when they get hit to that exact same second with web traffic. Mm-hmm. It's just frustrating because you can't do anything and you don't know if you're doing something wrong, if the website's glitching, if your fucking computer's glitching. There's so many variables that you don't know what the answer is, and that makes me as a consumer very frustrated. Yeah. That I don't know, am I the one at fault? What's going on?
You don't have closure.
And then I go on to Twitter and be like, oh, I see 100 different mentions saying yeah. that they have the same problem. That's when I realized, I'm like, all right, man, there's no point of me doing this. And then next thing you know, like fucking 30 people are like, I copped. I'm like, what the fuck did I do wrong?
Yeah.
I just feel like that's why I always have a feeling that I'm very bad at buying shoes online.
My question is, why does it have to take one person that's not part of that company
yeah.
to report stuff like inventory levels?
Because they're not at liberty to say. They're very secretive.
But they're going to leak out stuff to other people, whether yeah, it's true or not.
A leak's a leak. If they are, in fact, the ones allegedly leaking all this information, then like they don't have to take responsibility for these numbers, may it be accurate or not, right? That's why a lot of that's why a lot of stores will not say how many pairs they got, just in case people are counting fucking heads and, you know, and then some pairs are promised to other. Like, that's just my guess of yeah. what's happening. If they don't disclose the number of pairs available, they don't have to own up to anything.
Mm-hmm. But that also drives hype.
True. If nothing drives up hype more than the unknown, really. How hard something is yeah, to but get.
With all due respect, fuck hype right now. It's not about hype. It's about customer service.
Yeah, that's the one thing that's still not sitting right, because Nike has owned up to the fact that it was a technical error.
Yeah.
But now they're taking the Canadian allotment elsewhere.
See, that's, what I think is...
But that's sense. Allegedly, though. That's allegedly...
What weak. I think happened is Nike, if they did actually... owned up to this being a technical issue, I think these Royal Ones cannot be sold the way that they have been distributing their shoes online, and they can't fix this technical error to fairly distribute these shoes to consumers.
That's true, because I mean, fuck it, it's gonna be the same thing, right?
Because someone that is not Nike.ca is making this decision. Nike.ca is probably begging these guys, like, let us sell these shoes. Just let us. This is just me fucking imagining how this thing's going.
Yeah.
Nike.ca is like, please, just give it to us. Like, we're going to sell it. Trust me, this is going to work this time. And then whoever's holding the fucking 95% of the remaining stock is like, I don't know, man. You guys can't get your shit together, so we're going to give it to Europe. Like, the way that they've been doing it has been fucking flawless, so Europe will get it.
But now, is it any different?
You're describing as three different entities. Nike.ca, Nike.us, Nike.uk. Like, those are three different entities, but it's they're making decisions for us? Like, I don't get that.
Maybe. Maybe the whole entity of Nike. These are all just me fucking conjuring a storyline.
I know we're just bullshitting here.
But like the entirety of Nike, let's just say, who has the final say on who gets what in what region? They're like, Canada, you can't get your shit together, so you don't get any now.
Yeah, but that's their own problem. That's still an internal Nike website issue.
Here's another question to you. So what's the difference with R.ca system or checkout compared to a European checkout system
sneakers app?
Yeah, but for now, But that's not entirely true because they don't have sneakers, and there's sneakers Nike.com is still a functioning US e-commerce website.
Plus, Europe has more people than we do. So if their demand is higher and they can do that traffic, why not share that technology to us?
That's why it doesn't sit right. I mean, it's with a multi-billion dollar retail company or headphones out like all it would take is a few hundred thousand dollars to go in and completely revamp this.
We don't know any of this for sure, but yeah, we're just guessing.
You could redistribute it through all the Nike retailing stores.
No,
just to give people.
Here's the thing, man. Like, once something like this fucks up, they don't
risk it. They just fucking move it somewhere else. It's easier, right?
Like, this is just today's Wednesday. This is what we know as of today. By the time this releases, maybe something has completely changed. We don't know. But as of right now, it looks like Canada's or .ca is not going to get any of.
So it's a royal fuck up.
Yeah, it's a royal fuck up indeed. I have a huge issue with this. Even though I was able to get a pair from a local raffle, I'm still very disappointed with how this was handled, and a lot of people that purposely waited to not buy these at resale or did not put in all the effort. Well, that's on you. Not put in all the effort to enter local raffles, like. And we got to also think of some of these other locations that have sneakerheads that don't have them available in their area.
Yeah,
and their only hope was Nike.ca, right?
That's the main thing, because I remember what it's like trying to cop sneakers living in northern Alberta. It's, you wait until they hit eBay. And there were times where I'd have to wait until they hit eBay in the early 2000s.
So those are the people that probably lost out the most when it comes to this release, that they were finally going to have a release wide enough and stocked enough to cater to all these people that might not have a chance to get them in their store locally. So these people that were looking forward to it got kind of cheesed off, right, probably.
What I feel bad is for those influence people that, you know, report that they have, you know, like kick steals, and they get shafted, and you know that's PR. That
shoot the messenger, man. Yeah, that's exactly the fucking internet mentality, though. Like,
I'll be honest. Like, at one point, I was like, "Oh man!" Like, I wanted to unfollow because I was just choked. But at the same time, like, I understand. You know what? I know Kick Steals Canada. I know he works hard. I know he's there at like 3 a.m. tweeting if there's a restock or not.
Right.
But at that time, I was like, are you kidding me? Like, you told me that this is going to be... And I'm sure I'm not the only one that feels this. Like, I'm sure that people were, like, choked, too.
I'm almost certain that he was just reporting everything that he knew up to the minute.
Of course.
Nike, I'm pretty sure he works very closely with Nike.
But if
Nike
there's Canada, no face, there's going to be a scapegoat, and that scapegoat is the closest person reporting that information.
So Nike fucks up, and then KDC takes the heat.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Which is not fair, because whatever, whoever gave him that information...
Get me upset there, Pierre.
I'm still choked. That's why. Like, I mean, you're right, Joe. Like, there's so many people out there. I know kids that were like using online to cop something that they've never had, and then next thing you know, they can't.
Man, all these young sneakerheads that are just starting to collect sneakers, and a lot of young sneakerheads, I know it's hard for us to believe, don't have any Jordans yet. Mm-hmm. They all have UltraBOOST, NMDs, and sometimes even Yeezys. And for like younger collectors to be excited about a Jordan, I would want them to get these Jordans.
Yeah.
Like, I'd be like, all right, man, these are your first Jordans, fucking do it. I remember we were talking about earlier when Jason, one of your friends, asked on Instagram, whatever, he doesn't really regularly collect Jordans, well, how should he start? And we all said, Royal One. Should be easy to get. Royal Triple One.
Up. Yeah,
man.
He didn't, he didn't have to worry. He ended up getting the cause. So
mother.
Okay.
Instead.
So really?
But I have my neighbor's kids. He's 15, and he wants Jordans. He has UltraBOOST and things like that. Starting to, you know, do his collection.
Yeah.
And he was so stoked because he just had his birthday, and he wanted to. He had his money. He was ready to
make it rain. Yes.
Make it rain, and you know, like,
I'm gonna stay up till midnight.
And he was he was ready to rock and roll. And then I talked to him the next day, and he was like, did you get a pair? And I'm like, raffle, because we were talking about raffles. I'm like, did you go and raffle? And he's like, no, raffle, I didn't go any. I think he went to one place, or I don't even think he went.
So he's not like,
you got to do the raffles.
He's too, not a regular raffler.
Does he not?
I think
know?
He does, but he just doesn't. He doesn't have.
He was confident in his online.
He doesn't have the means to be like going out multiple days.
I forgot he doesn't drive. You
know, he doesn't drive, so it's like
way to be a mentor and drive him to those raffles.
Do it, I could next time. He can perfect. Fucking ask.
Kurt's his kids.
Kurt's his kids. Hop on in. No, that's Pierre. Pierre's peeps.
All aboard the raffle wagon.
I actually one time I asked Jamie. He was like, What do you think of this idea? And my idea was to do a raffle shuttle service. Take all these kids that are too young to drive and blah, blah, blah. And then
charge them?
Yo, that's pretty.
And charge them.
That's
like,
kind of cool.
If you look to your left, you'll see this store where there was a riot for this shoe. Let's go there now.
The stars.
And then I'll hit up all the different places and we'll do it a 2-day tour just so we can go to, like, you know how they split up the fucking raffle so you can't hit everything in one day?
Yeah, of course.
So we'll do a 2-day raffle tour and we'll be like, this is where I got this shoe and da da da. Your odds are not good here. So if you want, we can wait here. Da, da. I was always thinking about doing a fucking raffle tour and shuttle service and just charge these kids.
We could do a podcast. That's why we do it. We could do a podcast shuttle service.
No, I want to do like one of those like speaking tours, kind of like TMZ style,
the
like
real those bus Jay tours. Peterman tour.
Yeah, outside, we'll get that hop
right
on
the dumpster.
Yeah.
See, I'm
sure Pierre and Eugene want a certain type of bus used to.
Oh yeah,
here we go.
the bang bus.
Where's that
bang? I meant boom
bus.
Boom bus.
Give me your purse. Oh fuck. Anyways, so let's just wrap it up. So this Royal One release, we all got lucky with the local releases. None of us copped online from any store. Did Foot Locker or anything release online, or is it just Nike.ca for this thing?
No, they
a couple of boutique
in the States, right? Or in Canada.
Cancel.com, cancel.ca. Yeah.
Jesus Christ, I don't know.
So much hate, but that's true. It's the truth.
It's true, man. It's just
that's unacceptable.
Yeah, man. The writing checks, they're fucking cash, man.
And we're not afraid to call it out, like, because we.
It's not a legend. It's fucking fact.
It's the truth.
This is real.
Right? Yeah, everything that we say here.
It looks like 25% of the orders are actually shipping.
Yeah.
Maybe even
one out of four.
That's what do you guys think? Do you think like more than half of them shipped? Because I see a lot of canceled orders.
Canceled orders. They take the small percentage of interest that they make off of that money that they have.
Did we talk about which store this is yet? No.
Well, online. Sure. Okay. Yeah.
If you've had a canceled online order that you were pretty sure that you've copped and checked out and even paid for, let us know in the comments below. So this thing ended up being way more difficult. And we talked about how frustratingly difficult the bread ones were to cop.
Yeah.
This one ended up being even harder.
Yeah,
we all team copped. That's the bittersweet.
That's the best part. So it's morphin' time.
Welcome
again.
To this was
a hard one. This was a hard one.
Yeah.
No, bread? I have bread.
Pew, pew, pew,
no,
pew.
No, but you weren't there when you copped us with a team, right?
Now we can...
bread ones?
No, I was here. Yeah.
So I'm just waiting for them to release the Chicago ones again. Then I'm all good.
Will they release?
I got
It's only been a couple of
three
years.
Three times Space Jam.
Everyone will get three pairs.
We need shadows. And
the best is when you go
white.
Two times. Well, I just want to. I just want to be able to like cut it up, cut them all up, and make my own top three.
Yeah, that'll there be a go. Kurtz custom.
Oh wait, I do have the top three. Thanks, Kurtz.
Yeah. There you go.
I don't need to make my own.
No, cut up a top three and turn that into a top six because there's two shoes. Whoa.